Hay luz.
Are you perchance Radsom?
Yeah, that's me. How do you know my name?
Teelan mentioned you. You are his fellow researcher.
Oh, I see. Teelan sent you. Him and Tyrae are still getting on, okay?
Quite. Though she did give him a good scolding earlier.
Went to Alkemoth again, did he? I did warn him not to be reckless. But when it comes to his research, that boy has tunnel vision. To be honest, so does Tyrea.
Does she come here much as well?
No, hardly ever. She's even more focused on the work than Teelan. I couldn't begin to guess why she's so driven.
It must be about her mother after all.
Radsom, we have questions. About the Fog King.
I see. That's why you're so curious.
We need more to go on. What can you tell us?
Because of the Telethia's ether field, the Fog King and his fog beasts seem, well, unable to escape Alkemoth.
Ether field?
Yeah. It's the means by which Telethia eliminate any excess ether that they absorb. Now, the Fog King and his beasts happen to give off an awful lot of ether.
I see. So all Telethia in the vicinity flock there, to feed on the ether, and, as a result, keep the threat contained.
Oh, this hot noggin of Kino. It get worse if not shut up.
But my ether, it worked against Fog Beasts, but not the Fog King. Or rather, it didn't even seem to make direct contact with him.
Shulk, Melia, would you do me a favor and head to Teelan's lab, borrow his Telethia research notes for me?
Sure, we can do that for you.
There's something I'd like to look up about the Telethia's ether field.
Understood.
On another note, we heard that you spoke out against the Companions.
I voiced an opinion, yes. I can understand their impatience. Their ancestral home was right there. However, I couldn't abide watching them throw away more lives for nothing.
Nothing. Sounds quite stark.
At first, there were hundreds of us living here. But now? Well, you've seen for yourselves.
And all because of the Fog King.
Yeah. So I think you can see why I said what I said. If we end up extinct, we'll have won nothing.
Well spoken. But I'm sure the Companions would find those words hard to swallow. I'm sorry. Your people are no more free to go home than we are.
No need for you to apologize, Melia. In truth, it's not costing me any sleep. They seem to be catching on too. After all, they've stayed put since then.
When you put it like that. The people of Grandel, they're living under considerable strain, not knowing what became of their homes, and with no means of return.
Hmm. But that's also true of Maxis. His people lost their homes too.
Yes, but they're feeling desperate, and it's making them unreasonable.
It too sad.
We were like that too once, weren't we?
Yes, we were.
That true?
Hmm, but we learned, eventually. All because we wanted to protect the world. And we made that dream a reality. We brought down Zanza.
Overcoming our prejudice gave us strength in unity, because we shared a goal.
Radzim's folk, the companions, and us as well. We all share the same goal.
Defeating the Fog King and returning home.
Sounds like job for Hero Blanquino.
Just let Nene at him.
Thank you, everyone.
Mamma mia, what that thing?
Is that...
It's like the one we saw in Alchemoth, but much, much larger.
You're right.
Shulk, let's see if we can get closer.
Yeah.
I approach my limit.
Hang in there. Don't give up.
Ugh!
right?
Are you that? Are you that?
Hey.
This isn't going well.
Is that all the backbone you have?
Rah!
This isn't going well.
Is that all the backbone you have?
We cannot be reckless.
Going well.
It's just scratch. Even a very big scratch. Ooh.
This isn't going well.
Not to worry. Kino, good at improvising.
This isn't going well.
Not to worry. Kino, good at improvising. Yeah.
Come and see!
Looks like this area isn't very heavily cultivated. That might be why nature runs so rampant.
Big step for Nopon! Kino make this into Frontier Village Mark II!
Frontier Village, huh? I was amazed first time I saw it. All the pollen factories, built into that giant tree.
Nopon never use metal if can be helped. Except for Sister Pon, who like use Hom Hom Shield very much.
Oh, right. It's true, though. Ricky never did use a metal weapon. It looked more like a fruit of some kind.
Kino here, this is actually gumberry that store ether within. Kino just make it suck in ether, and then it shoot out contents like real rifle.
Is that right? I'm not sure I've ever seen a berry that big before.
Indeedy. Kino never see one lying around before, that for sure.
The plants that bear them must be very rare. I knew biters. But I didn't know you had curiosities like these.
Well, biter's still more popular. Little Pon Kino also wants to use biter, but no beef on wings, so could not carry properly. But then, when Kino gets in big sulk, Dada Pon go and pick gumberry from somewhere.
Ricky did. So he can be a model father. I'm impressed.
Yes, yes, Dada Pon is true hero Pon. This weapon only used now by Nopon 2, Wimpy to hold Biter. But Dadapon was first one to discover. Everyone jumped for happy when introduced.
Ricky is a man of many talents, huh? A true Heropon indeed.
Dadapon say, he get idea for making into weapon from Hom-Hom gun.
Inspired by a Hom's gun? Ah, Sharla's ether rifle then. Though if he was going to make weapons, I would have been happy to help him out.
How about if Shulk give Kino pointers? Kino's still not always hit target.
Pointers, eh? From what I saw, though, it seemed like you knew your stuff.
Kino also thinks so, but still sometimes miss.
Right. Then maybe you'd best learn how to properly handle the weapon.
Properly how?
Am I right to assume you've never really had proper training?
Mama, how shock knowing of that? Kino, state of shock.
I reckon the weapon's more beat up than it should be. You don't want that. More prone to malfunctions.
What Kino should do?
It's important to be as careful as possible. Handle it too roughly, and you could end up warping the grip. If the aim is a little off, it could potentially be because of that.
Shulk knows such things. Kino never figure out in a million years.
I've always liked tinkering with weapons. Even made my friend Ryan's weapon, in fact. That'll be why. If you need a weapon maintained, I'm your guy.
Shulk really second most awesome after Dadapon. Tell Kino more.
All right. But for now, let's reinforce this to help with your aim. In return, could you perhaps share some more stories?
Kino liked that deal.
Huh!
such very depressed.
What is it, Kino? Has something happened?
Miss Mary!
Why the sighing? It's unlike the bright, bubbly Kino I know.
What? Kino not allowed to be moody? Is sensitive, especially at age of now.
I see. Then I hope you'll forgive me. So something worrying you? Anything you care to discuss with me?
Doubt if can help. But maybe Miss Melly have some advice.
Oh, very well. In that case, I'm all ears.
Kino, follow Miss Melly and Shaw calls Skulky Light to come with.
Yes, quite.
But at start, Kino never think Kino come to such very far away place. That boy, when Kino leave, Kino not say bye-byes to Mama Pon. If Kino come back now, there's sure to be heck to pay. Mama Pon angry, wants to look like Chew Toy. Just thought of remember makes Moo Goga plunge.
Did Oka really have such force of character? But don't fret. It's only because she worries about you. That intensity is nothing but a sign that you are loved dearly, Kino.
Miss Melly Shaw?
Yes. I'd say she only scolds you because she cares.
Mama Pon get angry because love? Kino not really understand.
Look at it this way. Kino, you are her beloved son. If you were hurt, Oka would be sad, would she not? Therefore, when she scolds you, it's to try and ensure that you don't put yourself in harm's way. So, do not think it cruelty.
Oh, Kino, no! Everything resolved if Miss Melly just asks Mama Pon to tone down harsh when angry at Kino. If do that, even Mama Pon may become a bit gentler now, Pon.
No, that I cannot do.
Mama, why no?
You really need me to explain. Isn't it the mark of a hero, Pon, to take responsibility for their own actions? At least I believe Ricky did, to an extent. If you wanted to come with us, you should have asked Ricky and Oka's permission to begin with. Don't you think that's what a hero Pon ought to do?
Mama!
You'll find as you go through life, similar situations may reoccur. If they do, and if you act the way you did this time, nobody will acknowledge you as a true hero Pon.
Sneaking onto boat was naughty behavior.
Kino, once you realize you have done wrong, you must reflect on it and rectify it as soon as you can. If you let the chance slip you by, you may not get another.
Kino got it, Miss Melly. From now, Kino promised to never follow friends or Sneaky Skulky again. We'll follow friends proudly.
Oh. It seems I didn't explain properly after all. What you did wrong was to cause Oka undue concern. So you'll have to accept your punishment, put time into self-reflection, and next time, simply do better. That is the behavior that will let you grow on your path as a mighty hero.
Understood. Kino promise.
I wonder if he really understood.
All right. All right? All right?
is it?
Thank you.